What's in our bones, DNA, and feeds 8 billion people? Phosphorus. It's an essential element that sustains all life on Earth. It's also in your pee. More on that later. But the vast majority of it goes into making fertilizer. Why? Because without it, we wouldn't be able to grow enough food. The problem is that there's a finite amount, and roughly 70% of it comes from just one place. The bigger problem is that we're wasting most of what's already there.
Every individual is just throwing away a loaf of bread every day.
For countries like India, which is 90% dependent on imports, dwindling access could be alarming. Plus, phosphorus is also causing some massive algae issues. But if the world's food security depends on it, what can we do about the potential shortage? What alternatives do we have? And could our own pee save us? Thanks to a German scientist boiling hundreds of gallons of urine in 1669, we found phosphorus, the 15th element in the periodic table. Fun fact, he was trying to find out how to make gold. Anyway, what is phosphorus?
All organisms need phosphorus. It's an essential nutrient and an essential component of life.
This is Barbara Cade Menon. She's a renowned soil scientist based in Saskatchewan, Canada.
It's part of our DNA. It's part of our cell walls, contain phospholipids. It's part of our RNA.
Today, roughly 80% of the world's phosphorus is used for agriculture. Because it's a structural component of cells, it's essential for cell division and plant development. Without enough of it, plants are stunted and don't yield as much. We've been increasingly using these chemical fertilizers on farms since the post-World War II period. Together with crop engineering, it spurred the Green Revolution. This saw massive increases in crop yields, especially in the global south and places like India.
In 1916, our food production was like near about 80 million tons. Last year, our food production reached up to 315 million tons.
Sudeshna Bhattacharya is a scientist at the Indian Institute of Soil Science.
I definitely will give this credit to fertilizer application because before there was no knowledge about that.
Worldwide fertilizer use increased 6 times from 1950 to 2000. So where do we get all of it from? To answer that question, we first need to show you the world's longest conveyor belt system, which can be seen from space. It's transporting the raw material, phosphate rock, from the Bukra mine across the Western Sahara Desert. Roughly 70% of the world's reserves are in the Western Sahara, a heavily disputed territory currently controlled by Morocco, which the UN says has been unlawfully occupying the area. A rebel army has been fighting for its independence. The largest reserves are spread across North Africa, followed by China, Brazil, South Africa, and Saudi Arabia. The scarcity makes prices extremely volatile. During the global financial crisis in 2008, a shortage of phosphorus fertilizer shot prices up 500% and fueled riots in places like India, Kenya, Nigeria, and Pakistan. Phosphate rock is a non-renewable resource, and we can't substitute phosphorus in the growth of organisms. Some scientists have warned that we're approaching peak phosphorus, but Barbara seems to think otherwise.
I was a child in the 70s. I remember peak oil, and yet have we actually reached peak oil where there's a crisis? No, because it becomes economically feasible to find alternatives.
In fact, less than 20% of the phosphorus used in agriculture actually ends up in the food we eat. That's partly because phosphate fertilizer is notoriously inefficient. It binds easily with other minerals in the soil, which makes it unavailable for the plant.
We're like applying 100 kg of phosphorus. A plant is able to get only 8 to 10 kg. Some part will go to nearest water body, but maybe 80% of that will be precipitated in soil.
That's why the industry solution is to just chuck more on the soil.
Phosphorus was relatively cheap. Adding a bit is good, a bit more will guarantee profits.
This accumulated phosphorus is called legacy phosphate. How much phosphorus is lost in the soil also depends on the soil pH. Too acidic, like in wet climates, and it'll bind to iron and aluminum. Too alkaline, it'll react with calcium. But this has consequences. The use of chemical fertilizers increases the runoff of nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus into bodies of water. It leads to eutrophication, which kills off oxygen in the water. It also causes massive algal blooms, which can be toxic and produce earthworming methane when they die.
Contaminated water is plaguing through Southwest Florida's shores.
The San Francisco Bay Area is experiencing a toxic algae bloom.
And it's not just the waste from agriculture that's rampant. Phosphorus is everywhere, in our food, our tap water. So if we consume a lot of phosphorus, then that means...
Essentially what's coming out is the same.
This is Jenna Senekal. She's a researcher at the Swedish University of Agricultural Sciences and also started a company that turns urine and feces into fertilizer.
1 out of 10 people are like, that is disgusting. The amount of nutrients that are in urine is enough to grow 500 grams of wheat. So basically it means your urine, you could be producing a loaf of bread every day.
She and her colleagues designed a system that essentially boils down our excreta and retains its nutrients. How? With a urine-diverting toilet. These toilets can get expensive, and it leaves the problem up to the individual consumer. But Jenna says she's been approached by building companies interested in installing them in new houses. And her company already has a partnership with Swedish public toilet rental firms.
If we were to recirculate all of our urine, and we could actually replace 8% of the global demand of phosphorus.
This solution is starting to gain traction in the West, but the upside is that it's particularly adaptable for places that don't have plumbing, since it doesn't need water. Unfortunately, household pee is just a small fraction of all the nutritious waste on Earth. There's also phosphorus in sludge and industrial wastewater, not to mention manure from livestock and dairy farming. One of the most scalable solutions is to figure out how to get all of it out and reuse it.
Right now, the sewage treatment plant, it's to get the water cleaner. We're not looking at it as extracting resources. We're not thinking of it as mining resources, but why not?
The industry is still figuring out how to improve existing technologies to make large-scale removal economically viable. There's also been advancements in the methods of extracting phosphorus from animal manure.
There's no shortage of technologies. It's just right now, it's still more cost effective to ship rock from Morocco than it is to try to get it from all these other sources.
We can also start earlier in the process and help plants absorb more of the phosphorus. Recent research has shown that certain types of fungi and bacteria could be used in the future to improve crop yield and soil health.
AM fungi, these are actually group of fungi. They are a very good phosphorus scavenger, you can say. They can extend their hyphae and scavenge phosphorus from area where plant root cannot reach.
Scientists are still researching how these microbes could be used for large-scale farming, however. Transitioning to such organic agriculture takes time and could result in yield losses, a risk farmers are hesitant to take. But legislation could help move the market along. The EU recently legalized the sale of phosphorus recovered from sludge as fertilizer and is working on laws that will require more phosphorus to be removed from wastewater.
Phosphorus is actually quite easy to recycle. If the government all of a sudden says, hey, you have to recycle 15% of the phosphorus that's in your wastewater, then innovations finally have a chance to come to light and start to implement.
Frankly, the cost of it isn't going to drive a lot of innovation. When it was cheap, no one valued it. I am optimistic, and maybe I'm just optimistic in general, but to me, the recognition that it's there and we're talking about it, and maybe it will trigger the pee revolution.
So what's the phosphorus situation where you live? And do you know of any creative solutions dealing with it? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to click like and subscribe. See you next time.